Hello everyone. We're going to learn how to plot a graph in this video. Graph plotting is an important skill when you handle and present data. We have also seen past DSE questions asking candidates to plot graphs according to the information given. Mastering such a skill will help you perform better in exams. In general, when plotting a line graph, candidates should meet the following requirements: writing a title, choosing and labeling axes, plotting the data points, and joining the data points. Let us take a look at the following sample data from an experiment. In the experiment, a student immersed beetroot discs into different concentrations of alcohol and measured the intensity of the red color in the alcohol after 30 minutes. We will first analyze the independent and dependent variables of the experiment. The concentration of alcohol is the independent variable. The permeability of the cell membrane is the dependent variable. A more intense red color in the alcohol indicates that more red pigment has moved across the cell membrane, meaning the cell membrane is more permeable. Therefore, the intensity of the red color is a parameter for measuring the dependent variable. We can then write the title based on the independent and dependent variables. A common format of the title is the dependent variable in different independent variable. We can write the permeability of the cell membrane in different concentrations of alcohol as the title of this graph. If the question specifies that the independent variable has an effect on the dependent variable, the title may be written as the effect of the concentration of alcohol on the permeability of the cell membrane. You will score 1 mark as long as you give a correct title. If time is the variable shown on the x-axis, we usually write the title in a different format. For example, the title of this graph would be the changes in pH of a reaction mixture containing oil and lipase with time. After writing the title, draw the x and y axes on the graph paper. Label the x-axis with the independent variable and the y-axis with the parameter for measuring the dependent variable. Remember to include the units. Up to this stage, you score 1 to 2 more marks. The remaining marks are given to the plotting and joining of data points, usually 1 mark for each set of data to be plotted as one line. Let us follow the steps below to get the full score. Before plotting, we shall first take a look at the data and identify the maximum and minimum values of each variable. We can then set a suitable scale so as to make full use of the graph paper. Now refer to the data shown. Setting 10 minor divisions on the x-axis as 10% and 10 minor divisions on the y-axis as 5 arbitrary units allows all data points to be shown and occupies most of the space on the graph paper. If all the data points are greater than a particular value away from the origin, you may place a break symbol on the axis to skip an unnecessary range so as to make good use of the graph paper. Many candidates forget to label the origin when they plot graphs. Make sure you have done so before you proceed. After setting the scale, you may refer to the values of the independent and dependent variables to plot the data points. In general, we are not sure about how the variables change between the data points. Therefore, you should draw straight lines to join the centers of consecutive data points with the help of a ruler. If you arrive at this step, you will score full marks. But you have to be careful not to extend the line to the origin unless it contains data. This is because we are not sure about the changes in the variables beyond the scope of the experiment. If you wrongly extend a line to the origin, you will lose the mark for the correct plotting and joining of points. In some cases, such as estimating the concentration of a solution that is isotonic to a tissue, we do draw a line of best fit instead of joining data points with straight lines. The reason is that the data show a linear trend as expected. A line of best fit represents the entire set of data and may be used to estimate unknowns. If similar questions appear in the exam, drawing a line of best fit may be more appropriate. If you plot more than one set of data on the same graph, you should use different symbols and line styles to plot and join points belonging to different sets of data. Last but not least, remember to include a key. If you follow the steps above, you will not have a hard time plotting line graphs anymore. If you enjoy this video, do give us a like and share this video to your friends. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thank you for watching. See you next time.